Good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to the Cardinal Sports Network's presentation of Trinity Valley Community College Basketball. Live from Athens, Texas in Cardinal Gym, I'm Benny Rogers, the Assistant Sports Information Director here at Trinity Valley Community College, and I'm joined tonight by Athens Daily Review Sports Editor Jason Larson. And we have a doubleheader for tonight, and folks, we've got a real treat in store for you for tonight, because tonight we've got the two of the second-ranked teams in the nation playing here tonight. In the women's game, we've got the Lady Cardinals, of course. They're 20-0 on the season, ranked number two. In the men's game, San Jacinto's men, 17-1, are ranked number two in the nation, Jason. So it should be a good night of basketball.
It's exciting, Benny. I don't know that there are many situations where you get to very closely top-ranked teams in the same gym. Of course, it's a men's game and a women's game, but it's a good night of basketball. Two halves of basketball for these fans to really enjoy, just some really good quality play.
Yeah, it should be a great game, folks. Where Lady Cardinals, of course, are 20-0, as we mentioned. They're coming off a victory on Monday night over Angelina, Jason, on the road. And one thing we should mention is the Lady Cardinals now are playing their fourth game in 7 days.
Yeah, and that's pretty tough, going with that many games. Of course, they had a little bit of a scare Monday night. They trailed 35-31 at the half, and found a way to pull it out in the second half. Shaquayla Caples had a big game. Of course, she's the conference leading scorer, so they pulled out of that. And you hear on TV all the time, maybe, a four-game stretch in 7 days is tiring. But, with as young as these kids are and as highly energetic they play, the level of basketball they play, you kind of think that probably doesn't affect them too much unless you have a lot of long travel involved.
Well, Jason, we'll take a look at the conference standings and look at just where the Lady Cardinals are in the Region 14 conference race. Of course, they're 8-0 in conference, and they're setting the pace there. We'll take a good long look at them here. Kilgore, of course, is 6-1. And Lon Morris, other than the Lady Cardinals, is the hottest team in the conference. They've won 9 straight, and you can see where they position themselves really nicely in the race right now.
Yeah, when you called that last week, you talked about Lon Morris being one of the hottest teams in the conference, and they haven't disappointed. 9 straight wins is big, and it's just one more team. It seems like there's one more team every year that just finds a way. It seems to me like last year it was Angelina, and of course Tyler's always been tough, and now here's Lon Morris. So it's a good conference race kind of shaping down, and as good as the Lady Cards record is at 20-0 and 8-0, they're really not in any position at all to let up. Not that they would, but they've got to keep playing good basketball and winning games, because they want to try to be in the best position they can be as they head towards that regional tournament.
We'll take a look now at the games going on tonight, other than this game here at Cardinal Gym. Of course, the Lady Cardinals earlier this season defeated San Jacinto in the game played in Houston. I think the score was 88-66. But you look at tonight's action on the women's side, Jason, and anything that jumps out at you maybe?
Well, I'd be interested to see that Angelina at Tyler game. Of course, Parrish has got that long trip at Blinn and then Jacksonville at Kilgore. It's all – nothing really jumps out at me. That Angelina at Tyler game seems like it's going to be a pretty good one. And, you look at that men's side, and that's where, I'm a little more intrigued. But, every night you never know who's going to win one of these ball games. So,
yeah, one thing I wanted to say is you got Angelina tonight. They're at Tyler in a game which Angelina's going to need to win, because I think they've dropped like 4 in a row now at this point. And, you're getting to the middle portion of the conference race, and it's not a time to go on a losing streak.
Yeah, definitely not. And like we were just saying, too, there's just – even for the Lady Cards, a 2 or 3-game slip would be, not devastating, but it surely could have a big effect on, as far as seeding goes when you get to that regional tournament.
We're about 4 minutes away from tip-off here at Cardinal Gym. We will tell you that the San Jacinto Lady Gators are 6-12 on the season, 1-5 in the conference. Coach Eric Taylor's in his third season at San Jacinto. He is now, counting this season's records, he is 16-55 on the season. The Lady Gators are led by Jaleesa Allen. She's averaging 13.5 points a game, which is 8th in the conference. She's hitting 79% of her free throws, which is 1st in the conference. And she's averaging 2.6 steals. So she's without doubt the leader for the Lady Gators.
Yeah, no doubt. And one of the things I'm curious about, as we've seen, we broadcasted last week, is just kind of seeing how teams approach coming into Cardinal Gym and playing in the number 2 team in the nation. Of course, last week, came out and just came out firing. So, you have to wonder if San Jack is not going to try to do the same thing in here, just come in here and shoot away and kind of see what happens. They've got to limit turnovers. They've got to deal with the press.
And, Jason, we're going to take a look at the Lady Cardinals game-by-game results. And, of course, we mentioned that they're 20-0 on the season. Well, I guess we don't have that graphic just now, so we apologize for that. But the Lady Cardinals have won 20 in a row. They're 8-0 in the conference. But the interesting thing about it is, Jason, in the last three home games, the Lady Cardinals have scored over 100 points in each of those three games.
Yeah.
Now we've got it, so we can actually take a look at it. The folks at home can take a look at it. But you look at the Panola game, 115, the Tyler game, 103, then all the way back to Southwest Christian in December, 106. So there's just something about playing here at Cardinal Gym that really brings out the best in the Lady Cardinals.
And it's kind of a throwback, and that's certainly nothing against any of the teams that played here before, here between, you know, the Budke years and the early Land years and now. But, you know, that's the kind of thing that you got used to seeing when you came to Cardinal Gym, was seeing, you know, walking in the gym. If you happen to be coming in for a men's game, you know, you usually saw three digits on that scoreboard. And it's just exciting. It's exciting for the fans. I think the players dig it. You know, I think that everybody kind of likes to see that, except for the team that's getting scored against, really.
And one thing I would like to point out before we lose our graphic is, of course, the Lady Cardinals have San Jack tonight. Then Saturday they go to Lon Morris, what's going to be a huge game now with the way Lon Morris is playing, and assuming the Lady Cardinals take care of business tonight. And then next Wednesday night, of course, we'll have our next webcast when Blends here. And then finally after that, the Lady Cardinals are going to get 7 days off. There's going to be seven deserving days off.
Yeah, and that will be a good time for them to get a good break. And, you know, like we just said, you know, we don't think that maybe 4-7 kills them too much, but they can certainly use the break. And that'll give them time to also adjust and work on some things maybe that they've seen and been able to break down on film.
We want to mention, folks, that tonight we should have a nice crowd. The student body is back. Classes resume Tuesday. So the Cardinal Regiment is here tonight. You're going to hear them in the background. The Cardets are here. You'll see them perform along with the Cardinal cheerleaders. So you're really going to get an atmosphere tonight of what basketball is like at Cardinal Gym on the Trinity Valley Community College campus. Also, I know Coach Brad Smiley's got several football recruits today, and I think they'll be in attendance at the game tonight, so they're going to get a good picture of what life is like here at Trinity Valley. Lady Cardinals are going through their final warm-ups here. We're about a minute away from the pregame activities. We'll have the national anthem introduction to both teams, and then we'll be underway. Again, I should mention that the Lady Cardinals handled San Jacinto down in Houston back in game played back in December. I think the score was 88-66. Got up to a slow start, as I remember, but then turned it on. Of course, the Lady Cardinals' success is all predicated by the press and its effectiveness.
Yeah, and I think last Wednesday, we saw that. So they really ran to perfection. They really disrupted a lot, and it turned into a lot of points. As you saw, they scored the 100-point mark for the third time at home here this season.
I'd like to mention to you, folks, we're glad to have you watching along the Cardinal Sports Network tonight, and want you to, if you get a chance, to drop us an email at csn@tvcc.edu. You see it there on the screen, and we'd like to hear from you. Let us know about our webcast, and let us know where you're watching from, because that really helps us to know is what parts of the country and other countries that we're reaching, because the Lady Cardinals, of course, have players from Toronto, Canada. We're gonna mic down for just a second here as we're going to have the playing of the national anthem.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Cardinal Gym at Trinity Valley for tonight's game featuring San Jacinto Lady Gators and your Trinity Valley Lady Cardinals.
the Cardinal Regiment with the playing of the national anthem. Now we'll have the introductions of both lineups, and then we'll be underway here in this Region 14 conference game. Again, the Lady Cardinals 20-0 on the season, 8-0 in conference play. San Jacinto 6-12 on the season, 1-5 in conference play. McGrath is a 5'10 freshman out of Terrell, Texas, nearby Terrell. Wendy Mitchell is averaging 2.4 blocks a game this season. Rian Davenport used to play here at Trinity Valley.
She did.
So kind of an interesting starting lineup there for the Lady Gators with Jaleesa Allen not in the starting lineup, their leading scorer on the season. Now we have the introduction of the Lady Cardinals, of course. Sabrina McKinney's averaging 3.8 assists for the Lady Cardinals. Jasmine Scott, who also played on the Lady Cardinal volleyball team, is averaging 15.1 points a game, which is 6th in the conference. Janae Baird's averaging 9.1 points a game and has hit 18 three-pointers. Alicia Robinson is a freshman, and she's the cousin of Brittany Dukes, a sophomore on the squad. Of course, you got Shaquayla Caples, who's leading the conference with 21.1 average, and has hit 29 three-pointers and is averaging 2.7 steals on the season. We're ready to get underway here tonight in the Region 14 Conference doubleheader, featuring the number 2-ranked Lady Cardinals versus the San Jacinto Lady Gators. And in the nightcap tonight, we'll have the Trinity Valley Community College Lady Cardinals, who's very hot right now. And we'll talk more about that as the night goes on, against the San Jacinto College Ravens, and they're ranked number 2 in the nation.
Why can't they just have the same mascot?
Well, it'd be easier on some of us.
It's hard on slow-thinking guys like me to memorize all that kind of stuff.
Again, we got a crowd, a late-arriving crowd, I guess you could say, but it is nice to have the students back on campus and in attendance tonight, and it'll fill in as the night goes on because, like I said, we've got several football recruits here, and the football team's occupied with them right now, but they'll all be here in a minute. And I think Tasha Spain, the volleyball coach, even had some of her recruits on campus today that she's going to sign for next year. And I know Ashley Johnson, the softball coach, had a big signing ceremony today when she signed 8 new Lady Cardinal softball players that will be here for the 2011 and 12 year. Lady Cardinals control the tip off to Caples, puts up the shot, knocks it down. 2-0 Lady Cardinals. That's usually a good sign if Caples hits that first shot. Maybe she's onward to a big night. Not that it takes it for her to have a big night, leading the conference score. Lady Cardinals in their patented full court pressure trapping defense, Jason.
Yeah, and boy, when you talk about Caples, usually when she steps on the court, that's a big night.
Caples with the steal, 3-on-1. Lady Cardinals have a number. They're going to throw it away. No, Barrett saves the ball. Back over to Robinson, out front to McKinney. Scott feeds Robinson down low, move, no look pass to Scott. We're going to have a held ball, and the ball's going to go over to the Lady Gators.
Not a bad start for Trinity Valley, high energy.
Well, it's not. Of course, they had the numbers there, though, Jason, had the 3-1 and didn't get points out of it, so I guarantee you Michael and Kenya Landers will not be happy with that, but they will take the turnover that they got.
Well, like I said, I'm always a fan of go ahead and trying to drive the hoop and get to the free throw line if you have to instead of getting too cute down there, but what do I know?
For Gwen, controlling the ball for the Lady Gators. She gets it back, goes off into the corner, three-pointer up, no good. Rebounded by McKinney. That was Hewitt that put up the three-pointer. McKinney on the attack, dishes it out to Caples. Caples from the baseline, Caples knocks it down. 4-0 Lady Cardinals, all 4 points to Caples. And we have a quick timeout by Eric Taylor, the head coach of San Jacinto. He's seen this before, Jason. He knows you don't want to let the Lady Cardinals get on a roll to start.
Yeah, and golly, I'm with you. When you see Shaquayla Caples have that kind of a start, you kind of think, wow, what kind of a night could it be? And I always think back and quite often think, gosh, how fortunate is this program to have, you know, such great scores? You have a Gloria Brown 1 year, and you turn around, you have a Shakayla Capel. Now, Gloria was great around the basket. Shakayla is just such a well-rounded player. She can score from anywhere on the court, and you see there, you know, she gets a layup, and she just turns around and hits a jumper like it's nothing.
I swear, Jason, some night she's going to light somebody up for 40. I just got that feel that she's got that kind of shot, and she's that type of athlete that's going to happen one night.
This could be the night.
Lady Cardinals resuming play, back in the press. Jewel with the basketball for the Lady Gators. Over to McWright, back over to Jewel. McWright, they break the press this time, get it down, have numbers. Passed up the jumper, going to make a move down low, up and no good. Rebound is going to be controlled by McKinney. McKinney on the move. The Lady Cardinals aren't going to take any time getting to the end. McKinney puts up the shot, knocks it down, 6-0. Lady Cardinals love playing at Cardinal Gym.
Wow, do they just look more focused than they have here early on? I mean, you're 20-0, but wow, they just look really impressive tonight here in the first couple of minutes.
Shot down low, partially blocked by Robinson. Held ball. This one's going to go over to the Lady Cardinals. Maybe what it is, Jason, they know they play tonight and don't play again until Saturday. Maybe they've been promised a day off or something. Checking into the game for the Lady Cardinals is Brandy Days, a 6'3 sophomore out of Harlem, New York. She can certainly match up with the defensive effort that the Lady Cardinals like to put up, I guarantee you.
And you know, I'm just starting to see just a little bit, you know, that Sanjak, one of their maybe strategies to come in is just be a little bit as physical as they can be allowed to do, and Brandy Days can certainly match that physicality.
San Jacinto had token pressure. Lady Cardinals break with no problem to the offensive end. Brittany Dukes is also in the game. Feeds it off to Days. Days up, no good. First miss by the Lady Cardinals, controlled by the Lady Gators. They're now on the attack. Ball out front. DeGrin puts up the three, no good. Rebound controlled by the Lady Cardinals off the loose ball. McKinney on the attack. Dishes it off to Days. Blocked, but be a foul called. She'll go to the line shooting two. Now, if you want to, the foul is going to be on Jewel, number 23. Now, Jason, if you want to, if there's a deficiency in the Lady Cardinals, and this will be admitted by Michael and Kenya Landers, it's at the free throw line. They're not doing well there this year.
Yeah, and of course, having been to Salina last year, us together, that you know that that's something you want to get straightened out. Of course, Salina's not a given, but even at the regional tournament, when you get these games where they're going to get really competitive, you're going to want to knock down as many of those free shots as you can.
Dace knocks down the first one. And the second. That's a good sign. Talked to Kenya Landers about the free throws today. She said, Benny, we've tried everything we know to do. We've shot dozens of them. We've not shot them. They've tried everything. They don't, but they're trying to push any button they can. Pressure defense by the Lady Gators, by the Lady Cardinals, rather, on the Lady Gators. Lady Cardinals up 8-0. Nice steal by Jasmine Scott, and makes that one easy. Cardinals sent a passing underneath the goal, and Scott was there. She made the steal and the rebound, the shot. 10-0, Lady Cardinals.
Not a bad start.
Not a bad start at all. Kawana Gardner has checked onto the floor for the Lady Cardinals. 5'8 freshman guard out of Los Angeles, California, wearing number 21. And Gardner tries to get the steal. And she gets the held ball, and that's, well, the ball's going to go over to the Lady Gators, so it's not a turnover. But the pressure is press is really causing the Lady Gators problems here.
Yeah, they are very much struggling with it right now, and don't appear to have an immediate answer.
There's a steal by Days. That's easy pickings there. Passes off to Gardner. Back over to Dukes. Puts it up. Knocks it down. 12-0 Lady Cardinals.
Four straight points off turnovers now.
And we have another turnover by San Jacinto. Taylor calls his second timeout. 12-0 Lady Cardinals with 16:55 left in the opening half. I would say that's a good start.
It is. Now, and here's one of the things I love about Trinity Valley basketball, especially the Lady Cardinals. It's 12-0 right now. We're, 3 minutes and 5 seconds into the game. The Lady Cards come to the bench, and Michael Landers is over there just coaching his tail off, you know, not letting up at all. And I think that's the way that your expectations have to be, and it's certainly what they've gotten used to here at Trinity Valley.
Well, it is, and the expectations here, of course, are very high. And the thing about it is, this squad has yet to develop, I think, that true killer instinct that Michael and Kenya both would like to see. And I know every chance they get, they're going to try to stress that to put teams away and not let up. So I don't see much let up at this point.
Well, 12-0 is pretty killer right now. We'll see how it goes 35 minutes into the game.
Ricky Dukes pressuring the ball. And foul's going to be on Jasmine Scott as Hewitt attempted to get the shot from down low about 3 feet. Misses the shot that draws the foul, so she's going to get a chance to go to the free throw line and get the goose egg off the Lady Gators side of the scoreboard. First free throw is up and no good.
At one point there, you saw the Lady Cardinals had four in the backcourt and had a pretty good numbers there out in front, obviously. You got basically two Sanjak players in the backcourt and four Lady Cardinals, and they still couldn't convert with three there. So,
and that one's no good. So the Lady Cardinals will remain 12-0 lead. Lady Cardinals working the ball around the perimeter. Turnover. Takes it coast to coast. Nice job that time by Hewitt with the steal and the layup. So at 16-23, Sanjay gets on the board for the first time, and the Lady Cardinals another turnover. This is what you don't want to see, Jason. You fall into these patterns where you get sloppy. Hewitt puts up the shot and in. Just like that, it's 12-4, and that's going to bring a ton of players off the Lady Cardinal bench. Kenya Landers is not happy at all with what she's seeing out there right now. The Lady Cardinals have gotten sloppy on the offensive end.
Yeah, they really did. Especially the cross-court pass there.
Pass to Scott. Another turnover. That's three straight trips. Lady Cardinals have turned the ball over. That's going to get a fresh four in. It's going to be Robinson, Caples, Osei, Barrett, and Melissa Jackson. So it's going to be a fresh five in. That's not going to stand, not those turnovers. Can't have that after you get off such a good start. Can't have it any time.
Yeah.
Pressure defense. Caples working on the ball. Lady Gators beat it this time down. Go to the corner. Hewitt, three-pointer. No good. Rebound is by Caples. Lady Cardinals have numbers. 4-on-1. Caples pulls up. In. Well, he's got a beautiful shot. Just a beautiful, soft shot.
She looks very focused tonight. 6 points now in early going for Caples.
Alano handling the ball for the Lady Gators. Dishes off along the baseline. Nice drive by McWright. Misses and puts the ball back out front. Jewel running the offense. Alanu on the drive but couldn't finish it off. Osei moving the basketball down the floor. Barrett puts up a three-pointer, knocks it down. Boy, when it's your night and you're hitting, Jason, there's just anything you put up is going to go in, seemingly.
This is unbelievable right now. The Lady Cardinals are 7-of-8 to start this ball game. Big part of that 17-4 lead.
Osei's going to be called for the foul, the bump foul. That's one thing. The Lady Cardinals got in foul trouble early against Angelina Monday night. Both Osei and McKinney picked up three quick fouls, and the Lady Cardinals in that game and in this game are playing without Cornita Bunch. She's out with an ankle injury, so they're down a point guard anyway. So when Osei and McKinney both got into foul trouble, it created some issues on the floor, but they overcame them and pulled out the win.
Well, that's depth, and that's where you know when you get to have so many players get so many minutes, key minutes, you know, that's what you have them in there for.
Lady Gators are getting some drives, but they're just not able to finish them off. That time it was Jewel. Osei running the offense for the Lady Cardinals. Over to Barrett, back to Osei.
Three rebounds already nearly going for Alice Robinson.
Man defense for the Lady Gators. Barrett drives the baseline, puts up the shot, in. We're at 19-4, folks, with 14 minutes left in the first half. Draws the foul, so she's going to get a chance to put another one on the board.
Well, you couldn't ask for much better than this. 6 minutes into the game, they are definitely pedal to the floor.
Shot is up and no good. There again, a great hustling by Melissa Jackson, keeping the basketball alive. He gets it out to Asay, and the possession remains with the Lady Cardinals. Capels over to Asay. Over to Barrett in the corner. Three-pointer up. No good this time. Jackson with the offside rebound. Puts up the shot. Looked like she was fouled. Wasn't called. Hewitt with the drive and the shot. I think she's got all 6 points.
She does have all six.
For the Lady Gators.
They're 3 of 11 right now.
Jackson puts up the shot from the baseline. No good. Rebounded by Robinson. Puts it back up and can't get it to fall. Jackson goes with the rebound. Loose ball out to Asay. Three-pointer. Knocks it down. Man.
What do you do? How do you cover?
They need to
stop.
They need to bottle this shooting up for the rest of the season.
They sure do. Save some.
Turnover. Steal by Barrett. Lady Cardinals don't have the numbers. Barrett's looking, makes a spin move, layup, beautiful shot. What a great move by Janae Barrett.
That, is that knee bothering her anymore?
I don't think so. 24-6 with 12:50 left in the opening half.
That made my meniscus ache just a little bit.
Jewel got great penetration, Jason. I know that's got a concern there to Michael Landers because he's up and he's giving somebody the evil eye, and she draws the foul. She doesn't get the shot to fall.
Well, and Kenya Landers came over here, you know, walked about halfway to the scores table and just put her head down like she was sick to her stomach. So, you know, that's about the only thing the Lady Cards haven't been able to do right is stop that inside penetration.
And Jason, here's another great strength of the Lady Cards. You look at when they make these subs, which are frequently, there are four or five players going out onto the floor. And that's just hard for teams that just not going to have near the depth the Lady Cardinals have to contend with. You may play with them for a little while, but eventually it's going to wear you down.
Yeah.
Next free throw is up and no good. Wow. Controlled by Scott. We're still at 24-6. McKinney on the attack. Gets a pick by Scott. Over in the corner to Brittany Dukes. Barrett in the corner. Drives the baseline. Puts up the one-handed jumper. Gets the roll. Ooh, Janae Barrett's hot tonight.
She sure is. Just doing a great job creating shots.
Had the press then and the steal. Dunn wasn't quite looking, but she does get the turnover after all. So great job of hustling by Alicia Dunn. McKinney moving the basketball quickly to the offensive end. Dukes out front, wide open, turns it down. Barrett drives the baseline, taking candy from a baby tonight, folks, with Janae Barrett playing like that.
Nice, unselfish move, too, by Brittany Dukes to pass up a three that she probably could have taken.
28-6. I know the Lady Gators got to be thinking, this isn't the team we played at our place.
It's 11 points already for Janae Barrett.
Going to get a call here going against Janae Barrett. You got to like the intensity with which the Lady Cardinals are playing as well, Jason.
I think every game they ought to play that way. It's fun for the fans, and it's great for them, too. And especially like talking about with the depth, you know, if you've got 10, 11 girls over there that are going to play that intensity, there aren't many teams that are going to be able to hang with them this season. Anyway.
Got to be careful here. You don't want to get an injury, of course, but Lady Cardinals are going all out and hustling. And of course, Sabrina McKinney went after the loose ball and was tripped. And going to be a foul called against the Lady Gators. That's going to go against Jewel. I think that's her second foul.
Very scary foul there, too, because McKinney's knee was kind of pinned under her for just a second. You've seen that kind of injury lead to a lot worse, but here she is. She's up and ready to go.
Lady Gators are playing man defense against the Lady Cardinals, and most teams in this league choose to play a 2-3 because they have this thought that it gives the Lady Cardinals problems, and their half-court offense is not quite what it needs to be against it. Of course, you know, 20-0 record, is the proof is in the results.
Yeah, that's. We just saw the sixth turnover. Now I guess they are saying that, well, appeared to be a turnover by San Jacinto, but maybe Lady Card got a fingertip on it.
Must have, yeah. Shepherd inbounds the basketball. Delano. She drives the basket, puts up the shot. No good. I tell you, the Lady Gators have gotten some good shots, but they just haven't converted. Capels puts up the shot, knocks it in. Has she missed tonight?
No.
She's got a perfect night going.
4-4 now.
Lady Cardinals continue to press. Caples gets a piece of the ball, but is saved by the Lady Gators. Down low. There again, another good look. Just aren't making the shots. I don't know. Well, there's a turnover. There's an easy steal for Caples there. We have an injury on the other end. McKinney is hurt as Caples is fouled. Not exactly sure what happened to Sabrina McKinney. Doesn't appear to be anything involving her limbs. It looks like she might have taken a shot to the head, possibly.
Yeah.
Got a shot in the eye, yeah.
She just said my eye. She's tough. She is tough. Of course, foul here was on the other end against Daisy Ilanu.
That's the only thing that slowed down the Lady Cardinals to this point.
A shot to the eye.
Caples goes to the line. First one is good. Mercy, we're 31-6 with 10:31 left in the opening half. Second one's good. Well, Jason, at this rate, it's going to take a while to figure the Lady Cardinals scoring tonight and not so much on the Lady Gators.
Yes, that is correct. 10 points, I can tell you, for Caples right now, the conference leading scorer.
She had 26 against Angelina Monday night. Three-pointer, no good. Rebounded, put back. It's not going to fall. Boy, the Lady Gators just can't get a shot to fall. Great hustle along the baseline by Jaleesa Allen, but the ball remains with the Lady Cardinals. Allen just now getting in the game. She's the top scorer for the Lady Gators on the season. Gardner with the drive and knocks it in. Boy, everything the Lady Cardinals put up is just going in, Jason.
It's solid goal. I mean, and they're getting all kinds of rolls and everything. It's just very impressive. Six straight shots now hit by Trinity Valley as Gardner gets on the board.
Steal by Caples. Did a great job. Lady Cardinals have numbers. 2-on-1. Caples takes it herself. She's still perfect for the night. 36-6, 9:38. Well, this is like the Lady Cardinals of old we're seeing here, Jason.
Seven straight shots.
There's a long pass down court. It's a nice job of putting it up. Not going to get it, but Robinson's hustling and gets the loose ball. And then we have a whistle. Foul is going to be called on Carrier for the Lady Gators. Neither team is near the bonus. That's just the fifth team foul on San Jacinto. We like these kind of games in which the officials aren't blowing the whistle off so much. Of course, there's not really been a chance in this one. It's been the Lady Cardinals knocking down shots.
Well, we've had a 12-0 run so far by the Lady Cards, and now we're on an 17-0 run. That's how we get to 36.
Great pass inside the dace by Janae Barrett. And boy, the Lady Cardinals are just seeing everything tonight, Jason. It's just the best start we've seen them have to a game this season.
They've hit 8 straight buckets now. That makes it a 19-0 run and 38-6. Wow.
Lady Cardinals continue the pressure defense. Three-pointer. No good. Shepherd attempted three-pointer. Loose ball. Great job. There again, we see Jaleesa Allen got the loose ball, put the points in, and is going to be called, going to be get the free throw because of the foul. And that's just what we're talking about, Jason. She's the top performer this year for the Lady Gators. When you look at her numbers, she's averaging 13.5 points a game and 2.6 steals a game. She does miss the free throw, and we're 38-8, and that stops a 17-0 run, Lady Cardinals.
17-0 run,
19-0 run,
and now
Gardner. Oh. They are just shooting lights out tonight. They need to save some of this for Lon Morris on Saturday.
Well, I'm glad it's on video and it's on the webcast, so somebody's going to believe you when you tell them about it, because you just wouldn't think. 9 straight shots now. Just so hot right now.
Well, the Lady Cardinals just all over the floor. Look at that. You had Janae Barrett and Kawana Gardner just diving after that loose ball and not giving up on it and forcing the held ball, and possession belongs to the Lady Cardinals with 8:27 left in the first half. Eric Taylor talking to one of the officials. Nobody feels like he may be getting a fair shake.
Well, the fouls are even. What do you want? 32-point game here with 8:27.
Gardner with the ball over in the corner out to Dukes. Of course, Dukes is on the team last year that went to the national tournament and finished sixth. Barrett over the corner, three-pointer. This time she's not going to get the roll, and Gardner's going to be called for going over the back that time. That's going to be the 16 foul on the Lady Cardinals, up 40-8. 40-8.
40-8. And it's like you said, you know, Sanjak has just had a hard time. Here you see another turnover coming. That's Gardner to Alice Robinson.
Brittany Dukes controlling the basketball at the top of the key.
Yeah. Aside from the turnovers, just Sanjak's just had a hard time converting down low when they've had some pretty good looks.
Yeah, that was definitely a foul that time. You could see it as Shepherd pushed Robinson. It's just the 16th foul. Both teams will be in the bonus the rest of the way after the ball is inbounded. Dukes will inbound for the Lady Cardinals. To Robinson. No good. Dason, they're battling for the rebound. Got a held ball. This one's going to go to the Lady Gators. It's kind of fun to see Alice Robinson and Brittany Dukes on the floor together being cousins.
Yeah, and I think Alice Robinson has really come on. She's done a great job on the boards. You know, in our last webcast, did a great job in that game and just continues.
Here the Lady Gators take it down the floor. Barrett's going to be called for the foul. Lady Gators were definitely pushing the basketball that time as you saw McWright take it to the hoop.
Of course, and you know, hard to find fault, but right there, Janae didn't get a whole lot of help from Brandy Dace. Brandy was coming up that backside, but didn't really try to cut off the shot. We see the first free throw fall. 0 for 6 now from the free throw line for Sanjak. That's bad news, or maybe you say worse news.
Free throw is up, and this was no good. Controlled by Alice Robinson. You're right about Robinson, though. She's just a great rebounder, gets great position. Gardner with a three-pointer up and in. Oh, man. They can do no wrong tonight, Jason.
I'd hate to be playing them in a game of course for money tonight.
Bergwin pushed the ball to the offensive end, but it's slapped out of bounds. I'm not sure you give the block to.
Well, Sanjak's 3-19. Eric Taylor is hollering at the refs for a foul there. Just frustrating.
It's got to be, yeah. There's a turnover. Dukes with the still in the inbounds. Gardner breaks the goal. Dukes is going to take it herself. No, she thinks she tried to dish it off to Gardner. Loose ball. Dace battling. Brandy Dace battling is going to draw the foul. Well, this has just been an all-out effort by the Lady Cardinals. You wouldn't know that this is their fourth game in 7 days. If you just watched their effort tonight, you think maybe there's a little of a jet lag, so to speak, after playing so many games.
And I don't know anything about, you know, what it takes to play on this level, but, I mean, you're talking about 18, 19-year-old kids, 20-year-old kids. I mean, they may be better without a break sometimes, just playing a little bit hot. And, of course, I mean, if you've got a lot of long road trips or something, that might not be as good, but I mean, if it's affecting them, it is not apparent. It appears that they are only getting stronger through that little stretch.
Dace hits one of two. Gardner hustling and keeping the loose ball alive. That's got to be so frustrating for the Lady Gators because the Lady Cardinals are just flat hustling tonight and getting after it, as you expect the number two team in the nation to do. There is a turnover, though, going the way of the Lady Gators. Bergwin with the drive. See, that you can't have that now. You can't have those holes in your defense there because Lady Cardinals have given us some easy shots tonight. Robinson back out to Dace. Dace pulls up with a 15-foot jumper and knocks it down. There's your 6'3", 15-foot jumper. Turnover going to go to Alice Robinson on the steal.
What's the mercy rule in Region 14 conference basketball?
Randy Dace puts up the no-look jumper. No good. Robinson puts up the rebound, put back, and is going to be called. There's going to be a foul call, I should say. 46-10, she'll go to the line and shoot two. Alice Robinson, we told you, of course, is the cousin of Brittany Dukes, number 25 for the Lady Cardinals, but Alice Robinson, a 6-foot freshman out of Bossier City, Louisiana, one of my favorite cities.
Why?
Just love to visit there. It's a great place to visit.
Good-looking city.
It is. I don't ever see much of it, but it's a pretty good place to visit. Let's just put it this way. You can leave many of your many tax dollars down there in Bossier City.
Really?
Yeah, the tax rate, something else.
Wow. And here I thought it was just a beautiful, great-smelling city.
It is. Robinson at the free throw line to save us. Makes Second free throw. 48 to 10. Well, let's just hope the number two San Jacinto men don't play as well as the number two Lady Cardinals have.
That's right.
Well, the Lady Cardinals just continuing to play. And finally a timeout called as Jewel just couldn't break it. She was trapped. She was swamped by Jasmine Scott and Shaquella Caples, and she calls the timeout.
Now, I'm sorry I didn't mean to interrupt you. I just want to interject something here. I love football players who put a big hit on somebody and they get up and it just makes them meaner. You saw that Jasmine Scott and Sabrina McKinney had the sand jack put in their trap and came out of that after she had to call the timeout, and they were just giggling, you know, like they were playing marbles. I mean, they enjoy it, buddy. They like it. They love playing defense.
I know in visiting with Michael Landers early on in the season, they were having a hard time getting the Lady Cardinals to buy into the press, and that's what Lady Cardinal basketball is all about, folks. I mean, you can go all the way back to whenever, and it's all about the press. But I think they're finally buying in and see how productive it can be and how much easier the offense is when you're going off of turnovers and steals as opposed to having run a half-court game. And I think what you said just kind of emphasizes that, and that they were smiling. They were happy. This is fun.
Yeah, it is fun. I wouldn't mind getting a little PT today. And that's playing time, not pine time. Anybody would like to be in a game like this. And
how would you like to play on a team that played against that press?
No comment. Maybe sometime I will get a chance to show you.
Well, maybe you will. See a lot of folks I recognize in the crowd tonight. Folks, I see Danny Hughes here, the assistant women's basketball coach at SMU, and most recently an inductee into the Cardinal Hall of Fame.
Well, well.
Good to see him here on the recruiting trail tonight. Of course, Danny played for Leon Spencer here back in the mid-80s. Had a great career, then came back as assistant coach for a brief period. Lady Gators on the attack, trying to solve the Lady Cardinal defense. They've done a good job of getting some shots tonight. They just can't get them to fall. Meanwhile, the Lady Cardinals are getting everything to fall. There's a shot clock violation. Boy, I tell you, coaches love that when you get that shot clock.
And Portia Jewell gave the ball up and kind of just let out a howl like, what next? What? Now the shot clock's playing against us. It's just tough.
48 to 10, 5.5 minutes left in the opening half. Caples for three at the top of the key, knocks it down. She's still perfect, isn't she?
Six
of six, folks. Just a freshman, got a chance to be one of the great ones by the time she leaves here. Nice job of the Lady Gators getting the ball down low. That was Mitchell with the easy shot. There's Brittany Dukes puts up the layup, a good block that time. I believe that's going to be Bergwin with the block. 51 to 12. Again, this is nothing like the game that was played down in Houston back in December. San Jacinto gave a good account of itself in that one. The Lady Cardinals weren't pressing near the effective way they are tonight. Leisha Dunn down low, puts it up, can't get the shot to fall. Jasmine Scott battling for the rebound. It goes out of bounds, but it goes off of the Lady Gators, and the ball will remain with the Lady Cardinals.
One of the things that I like about Trinity Valley, you mentioned that people you see at the game, you see a lot of area high school coaches come to these games. I just saw Athens girls coach Jay Pimple walk in. I think coaches enjoy watching this kind of basketball. I mean, it's almost like watching film in person.
It really is, Jason. Brittany Dukes, 15 on the shot clock. Dukes puts up a shot. Nice one-handed jumper in traffic, too. She had to adjust her shot, puts it up, and gets it to fall.
Incredible. I don't know what the Lady Cards are shooting percentage-wise right now, but, wow, it's good.
Caples attempted to get the steal. The ball is retained by the Lady Gators. Bergman trying to figure out something. A three-pointer up and no good. It's going to go out of bounds, and it's going to belong to the Lady Cardinals coach. Folks, you're just seeing a clinic here tonight. That's all I can tell you is the Lady Cardinals are just just taken to the woodshed, as we use a football phrase.
Yeah, and that little possession by McWright was pretty clear how it's going. Just took a step, kind of stuttered, and then just shot an air ball. What do you do? I really think you can see on their faces, the question is, what now? What do I do?
Jackson underneath, got it. It's going to be interesting to see what approach Michael and Kenyon Landers take in the second half in regards to the press. They're already pulling back out of it now, which I would suspect they would. But, you know, you don't want to lose that intensity because you want to have that great feel for the press going into the Lon Morris game Saturday. Man, they're giving them fits here in the half-court game. Jackson with the steal. Going to take it all the way, put it up, and knock it in. Great job by Melissa Jackson with the steal, and Eric Taylor just goes to the other end of the bench and just sits down. I mean, what do you do as a coach?
I mean, she was in danger of a five-second call, had to give it up, kind of.
Three-pointer in the corner, no good. Hewitt put up the three-pointer. Caples on the attack, dishes it off to Osei. Osei over to Gardner in the corner, puts up a three-pointer, no good. Rebound underneath, good job that time. Wendy Mitchell. Lady Gators just hammered that time. Jewel took the pass from Bergwin. It was just hammered underneath. Fouls on Alicia Dunn. I think you could have picked two or three Lady Cardinals to call that one on. 57-12.
Alicia was just the tallest one standing around the foul.
Free throw is no good. There's nothing falling. It's just going to be a long, miserable trip for the Lady Gators. That's just the only way to describe it.
It's 0-for-8 now from the free throw line.
Crowd's filling in really nicely here, Jason, as the women's game reaches halftime. See the Lady Cardinals softball team in attendance. Many of the volleyball players are here. Cardettes are here. They'll be performing at some point tonight. Cardinal Regiment, you'll hear them at halftime. Second free throw is no good. Rebounded by Dunn. Over to Osei. Lady Cardinals quickly on the move. Osei dishes off to Jackson underneath. Loose ball. That's a great job that time by the Lady Gators, diving for the loose ball and forcing the held ball. Ball remains with the Lady Cardinals.
You got to give Sanjak credit for getting on the floor for balls like that. I mean, this is a beatdown right now, and it's hard to play in a beatdown.
Pass goes over to Nina Cook, her first action of the night. She passes to Dunn down low. Dunn puts up the shot, no good. Gardner controls the rebound. Gardner thought about the three, goes on the drive, draws a foul. Lady Cardinals are in the bonus. See Coach Leon Spencer here tonight, legendary and Hall of Fame coach from the Cardinal men's basketball program. He attends most games still here. He's even at a few of the out-of-town games. Gardner with the free throw. Gets it to fall. And the second foul. Well, it's safe to say I think the Lady Cardinals are going to have a 60-point first half. That's just they go stone cold.
Can you remember the last time they had a 60-point half?
Well, there's been some. I don't remember the last time. No, I can't remember. Maybe a game early in the season, possibly. I remember they had close to 60. Oh, there's an unforced error there. It's token pressure and just not going the Lady Gators' way. I mean, I don't know what you say if you're Eric Taylor at halftime. I mean, well, there's a. And Leanne Osei loses ball out of bounds. She's making her argument that the ball went off of the Lady Gator, but she's not going to win that argument.
Not at 59-12.
Lady Cardinals with pressure, not full court pressure, of course. They're still defending the ball. Great job by Melissa Jackson of not fouling. Nina Cook dishes off to Gardner. Gardner puts it up. Doesn't get the shot to fall, but draws the foul. She'll go to the free throw line. Nina Cook seeing some extensive action here in the first half. A 5'7 freshman guard out of Detroit, Michigan.
I think Eric Taylor is in dangerously close territory here. He's frustrated, and that loud voice you hear in the background is his.
First free throw by Gardner's good. And Jason, you called that right.
Well, it wasn't hard to see.
Got a technical foul on Eric Taylor.
So, I mean, golly, a 48-point lead.
I think when you get that first technical, I think the coach has to remain seated now, I think, the rest of the way. And some circles you do, I think. Official may not enforce that, but I don't think he's going to take much more off of it.
Well, now, correct me if I'm wrong, we only took one free throw shot there.
Right.
So I guess we're moving on to the technical now.
Right, right. Melissa Jackson shoots the free throw. Can't get it to fall. Lady Cardinals had a pretty good night, though, shooting free throws, so it's hard to complain about the free throw shooting. Second one, right now you can complain. She missed both of them. That's good. That's not what you want to do is when you're called that single out by your team to shoot the free throws on a technical and to miss both of them.
Yeah.
Now Gardner will go back for the second of her two free throws. She made the first one. And hers misses, but Dace is there for the rebound, and she misses the shot, and she's going to be fouled, so she's going to go to the free throw line to shoot two. Randy Day, 6'3", sophomore out of Harlem, New York, and now they can't make a free throw. Now,
four straight misses.
Problem is rearing his ugly head here, 60 to 12. You got to get these because you're not always going to have 60 to 12 leads. You got to hit them. Day knocks that one down. Now we have a timeout on the floor being charged to the Lady Cardinals, so we'll reset things here. It's 61 to 12 with 1:58 left in the opening half. Yep, we said 61 to 12. I'm not lying to you, nor is your screen.
Well, I'd like to say kudos to a friend of ours. Athens Review employee Rhonda Garcia and her husband Mickey brought us chocolate chip cookies. This is kind of like Tom Grieve. You know, they've got their fans that bring them cookies to the booth. So
we encourage that kind of thing.
We do. Yes, we do.
We encourage it very much.
And I love these cookies. Now, I will sell these cookies for $2 a cookie. Not to anybody sitting up here, of course, because that would not be right.
Haven't eaten many of Rhonda Garcia's cookies in the past. They would be worth that.
Well, I can't lie to you. It appears these were bought at a restaurant.
Well, it's still a nice thought. I thought she had baked us some cookies.
Come on. Yep. We need to share these cookies, but we also need to pace ourselves because it may be a very long night.
Can you tell it's 16-1 to 12?
Well, I wanted to ask you about the weather coming up, but I guess we'll save that for later.
Well, you know I'm always going to get into a weather report. I can tell you that Kilgore's leading Jacksonville women 34 to 23 at the half. Shot is up and in. Again, Kilgore's up on Jacksonville 34 to 23. Yep, Days took steps then, turns it over, 61 to 14. 1:34 left in the half. Another turnover for the Lady Cardinals.
Interesting, you know, the coaching methods that you can use here, obviously for the Lady Cardinals, is keep punching as you see that McBride drives in there and gets a bucket.
Yeah, that's another time of where she just attacked the goal and got the shot to fall. Nina Cook puts up the shot. The three-pointer goes in by Nina Cook, number three on her jersey. She hits the three-pointer, gets the bounce.
And, of course, for the Lady Cards, you know, if you're one of these bench players, again, it's a nice shot there you saw by Hewitt.
Yeah.
If you're the Lady Cardinals, you know, and you're one of these players that comes off the bench, you want to be one of the first ones to be called. So, obviously, you've got a lot of reason to continue to keep the pedal down.
The foul going to be called on Portia Jewell. Going to send Gardner to the line for the Lady Cardinals. Finally under a minute here left in the opening half. First one is up and not going to fall.
You jinxed him.
I did. I sure did. We just look up and down their percentages for the season, and I mean, they've got to be in 60-50 range somewhere. It's just not very good. She missed another one. Cook puts up the three-pointer. Now they're going to say this is with Deuce. Nina Cook, though, has got 5 points here in just a matter of seconds. She went 66-18. Well, the Lady Cardinals could, there's a turnover there. The Lady Cardinals could easily be in the 70s chasing with the free throws that they've missed alone.
Oh, yeah.
You can't say much about their shots because they've hit a great percentage of their shots tonight. The free throws have been a different story here as of late. Randy Dace puts up the shot. Knocks it down just inside the three-point stripe.
It's like that movie Pleasantville where they all shoot and everything falls. They're just not missing.
Shot's no good. Controlled by Gardner. She steps out of bounds. Frustrating for Alana, who put up the shot.
Well, I just looked up and I realized it's really a 50-point lead.
50-point lead. McWright gets the pass off the inbounds and gets the shot to fall. And we're at halftime, folks, here at Cardinal Gym on the campus of Trinity Valley Community College. It's 68-20 at halftime. Again, our halftime score is 68-20. We're going to step away here for a few minutes, catch our breath, and we'll let you enjoy the sights and sounds of halftime and whatever else we may have for you. And we'll be back with about 3 or 4 minutes left in the halftime. We've got a real yawner on our hands tonight. The Lady Cardinals have been most impressive. They reeled off a 68-20 halftime lead here at Cardinal Gym in Athens, Texas. Trinity Valley Community College are leading the San Jacinto Lady Gators. And Jason, there's just no other word to use but impressive.
Yeah, it's been very impressive. And I think the only thing that you can kind of hope for, if you're a Lady Cardinal fan at least, is to see them continue to kind of, you never want to rub anything in anybody's face, but there's nothing wrong. It's basketball. You got to score, you know, to just try to be as solid as you can, control the ball as well as you can, and execute as well as you can.
Jason, before we get started here in the second half, and that's coming up real quick, who led the Lady Cardinals in scoring?
Well, naturally, it was Kayla Capel. She was 6-7 in the first half. We thought she was perfect there. She missed, a third or fourth shot, but, you know, just an incredible first half, 15 points. Of course, conference's leading scorer. They also had Janae Barrett in double figures with 11. Melissa Jackson had, four. I have it kind of written lightly here. Kiwana Garden had 10 points. Brandy Days had 10 points. So just lots of impressive nights going on right now, and almost all the Lady Cardinals have scored.
And we're ready to get underway, and the ball will belong to the Lady Gators, down 68-20. Thank you all for joining us on the Cardinal Sports Network. Eddie Gators go on the attack immediately and get an easy shot in, down low from Wendy Mitchell. That's one of those easy buckets we talk about that just frustrate a coach. You want to make them work for it. And the Lady Gators certainly didn't have to that time, but what they did do was perfect execution. McKinney puts up the shot and knocks it down. The Lady Cardinals start off and match the opening point by the Lady Gators. Great job of Caples by controlling that rebound as she's on the attack. Lady Cardinals will have a number. She pulls up with the jumper. No good. Rebound by Bergwin. Oh, that's too bad. Lady Gators had numbers that time and threw it away. That's not the way you're going to make up a deficit of the size of the ones they're facing.
Yeah. I mean, if you're a coach, as a coach, do you tell your team in the locker room, don't give up? That, you know, I mean, of course, the game's not over, and miracles can happen. I don't say that to be funny, but it would be a miracle for them to come back from that kind of deficit.
Caples goes on the attack. The foul's going to be called on Hewitt. Be the first team foul of the half, 70-22. Caples is sporting a new hair look tonight.
I like it.
I do too, especially when she hits.
It leads to lots of points.
6 of 7 shooting in the first half.
I think if the Lady Cards do something crazy like score 120 or 130 points, you ought to braid your hair.
I should?
Yeah, sure. Just something I'm throwing out there.
I'm not sure they need that kind of motivation. Caples puts up the shot, one-handed, no good. Oh, McKinney almost picked her pocket, but didn't get it. Instead, they get a layup by Hewitt. 70-24. McKinney passes to Caples. Caples reverse layup, no good. There you are, Alice Robinson with the follow. She's always in the right spot at the right time on those rebounds. There's a great job of anticipating where the ball may miss.
Yeah, and rebounders are so valuable. I mean, that's an understatement, but you can have somebody that always has a nose for rebounding. That just makes a team that much better.
Lady Gators are executing far better here to start the second half, and that's Wendy Mitchell's second bucket to start the second half.
They're 3 of 4 here early on.
Great entry pass by McKinney to Robinson. She missed it. Oh, she can't miss that one. She's a little bit frustrated with herself, too. You can just read it in the body language. She knows she got a great pass by McKinney. Lady Cardinals want to maintain the momentum. Three-pointer, no good. Robinson on the rebound, on the attack, down to Scott, puts it up. Shot won't fall, but she draws a foul. Foul's going to be on Jewel. That's Jewel's fourth foul, according to the scoreboard. Jasmine Scott out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, 6 foot. Sophomore, played last year at Pensacola College, I believe. She played volleyball. Is that not right, Jason?
She did.
And this year she came to Trinity Valley and became the first female two-sport athlete.
Which is, I think, is a real neat deal. And when you talk to Tasha Spain about that, she said one of the great things, obviously she's a superior athlete, but, you know, when they got in some tight spots, she had that sophomore mentality and was able to lead them through.
Yeah, had a team of freshmen around her.
Now, see, she's Baton Rouge. I'm more Baton Rouge and you're more Bossier City. I like Baton Rouge because it's closer to New Orleans.
And you know why I like Bossier City, so we're even. Lady Cardinals not with the full court pressure defense, a little token half court press, not even trapping at this point. Got to continue to play good fundamental defense, so three-pointer no good. Dunn couldn't control the rebound. Possession stays with the Lady Gators. Hey, the Lady Gators are getting some good penetration. They're getting some quick shots, and that's just going to be a give-up foul by Bergwin. Three team fouls this half on the Lady Gators. Going to need somebody to throw the ball in, Lady Cardinals are.
Although things have been going so well, maybe they don't.
Maybe they don't.
Maybe Jerry King was ready to throw it in down there, or Milburn Cheney.
Pass goes to Barrett on the wing, drives the baseline, puts up a one-hander, no good. Dunn on the rebound, puts put back is good. Leisha Dunn, she's had a quiet night scoring. Is that her first?
Yeah, it is her first. And
we saw her have a 16-point outing, I think, the last time the Lady Cardinals were home in the win over Panola. I believe that was her season high. Melissa Jackson is going to be called for that foul. Melissa Jackson, a 6-foot freshman from Lyon, France. Is it Lyon or Lyon?
I'd say Lyon. What you do is you say something like Lyon, and if you kind of twang it, then you don't get in trouble for mispronouncing it.
All right. Nice jumper from the baseline. Didn't get it to fall by Raja McWright. Sabrina McKinney is really coming into her own at point guard for the Lady Cardinals. There's a three-pointer of Barrett, no good. She's really been steady here the last few games. Of course, the Angelina game, she got into early foul trouble, so you kind of throw that one out. But the guard position is one that the Lady Cardinals really needed somebody to step forward and emerge there. Of course, Kernita Bunch has been a great point guard, a guard for the Lady Cardinals too, but she's out missing her second game with an ankle injury. McKinney, give back, give and go to Dunn. Dunn can't get the shot to fall. Looked like she was fouled, but the ball's going to go out of bounds and going to belong. Stay with the Lady Cardinals, leading 76-26.
McKinney always reminds me of that fighter that just jabs and jabs and jabs until you're worn down.
Inbound goes to Jackson. She misses the shot. Rebound is controlled by Jaleesa Allen. Foul's going to be called on McKinney. I think Allen had almost given up on the shot, seemingly, but she's fouled, so it's going to be the second team foul, I think, of the half for the Lady Cardinals as Gardner checks in for Barrett.
And just to complete that thought, Benny, she's just so tough. She harasses you so much. She disrupts your game so much. You know, she does more than just play defense.
Allen on the drive, going to be a jump ball, and the possession is going to belong to the Lady Cardinals.
When you watch her here, of course, you can sit at home now and watch her play defense especially. She's always in your face. You just don't have a moment to let up. She's constantly got you thinking, constantly got you moving, and I can imagine that's pretty exhausting.
For some reason, the clock is not operating here at the arena. Now they're getting things sorted out as we see Alano on the drive. It's going to be a foul on the Lady Cardinals, and they played a full possession that time without a clock operating. I don't know if it was just not operating or we sleep at the trigger. .15:44. Free throw is good. And the second one goes down.
Well, for a team that was 0 of 9 at the free throw line in the first half, that's a good showing.
McKinney was kind of out of control on the dribble somewhat. Is going to get the benefit of a foul. Foul's going to be called on Alanu. Now, we don't want to get these teams in bonus real early and be shooting free throws the entire second half.
Especially
Gardner puts up the three-pointer. No good. Dukes with the rebound. Dukes goes back up the putback, no good. Dunn battles, but Dunn's going to be called for over the back. But when you got a 6'4 frame, you can hustle and give everything you got, but sometimes it just looks awkward and you're going to be called for the foul.
Yeah, and it looks like we're heading toward the bonus situation. We're just 5 minutes in here, and could be a long second half.
And Gardner's going to be called for the foul. Now we're just turned into a foul fest. The smooth start that we saw by the Lady Cardinals in the opening half is, we're not going to see it here to start this second half. Of course, I know they're going to lose some intensity with such a huge halftime lead, but now we're getting to these fouls, and there's going to be a lot of free throw shot this half at this rate. Remind you, we have the men's game to follow, and in that game, the San Jacinto Ravens are the number 2 ranked team in the nation, and they'll be taking on the Cardinals. who have really been coming on in late. They've got a nice 15-3 season going, 4-3 in conference play. Dunn puts up the jumper, knocks it down. Her outside shot has really been a lot better and more consistent this year, seemingly, Jason.
Yeah, she's real methodical about it, and it just looks good. She just looks comfortable doing it.
We mentioned before tonight's game that the Lady Cardinals in their last three home games have topped the 100-point mark, and it's hard to imagine them not doing so again tonight as well. It'd be a great streak to keep going, especially with three of those, what would be a four-game stretch, being in conference play. McKinney running the offense. Dunn flashes, puts up the shot. It's going to be fouled. Pretty good job of flashing across the lane that time by Alicia Dunn, and McKinney Spotner puts up the shot, draws the foul. Well, that's textbook there. I mean, if you're not going to get the shot, you definitely want to draw the foul. So Alicia Dunn will go to the free throw line to shoot two. First one is good. It's good to see those free throws dropping as we see wholesale substitution into the game for both teams. Again, we like the size of the crowd tonight, a Wednesday night crowd that is filed in here. If you're watching along the way, we'd like to hear from you. You can email us at csn@tvcc.edu. We'd love to hear from you and let us know where you're watching from. Brittany Dukes puts up a three-pointer. No good. Tipped away, but Gardner controls. Gardner drives baseline. Oh, nice layup, but she can't get it to fall. Alicia Dunn again with the pushing foul. She just get the wrong place at the wrong time sometimes on those rebounds. 79-28.
I'd like to see the Lady Cards pick up the pace a little bit.
Nice job by Shalitha Carrier down low. It's going to be fouled and have a chance to complete a three-point play. Lady Cardinals are just a different team when they're not in their press defense, though, Jason. I mean, they're just a different type of intensity, as you would expect, and it's just not as fluid for them.
Yeah, and, what are you going to do? You don't want to do that necessarily right now.
No, so. You definitely don't want to be pressing, no. Free throw to make the three-point play is good. Little token pressure by the Lady Gators against Osei. She beats it down the floor. Over to Robinson, to Barrett in the corner. Day's working inside. They turn that down. Barrett puts up the shot, no good. Rebound is controlled by Barrett. And she does take steps. She definitely took steps. Turnover on the Lady Cardinals. First one of the half.
And just three right now for Sanjak.
Now we have a timeout by the Lady Cardinals. Kenya Landers wants to talk this one over with the Lady Cardinals, wants to reset things, kind of refocus maybe just a little bit, pick up some intensity. You know, a lot of folks probably thought, when the college announced that Michael was coming back and he and Kenya were going to be co-head coaches, would that work, Jason? But I would have to say it's been a great experiment so far.
Well, I mean, maybe it works if you've got some confusion about who's going to do what, or, you just don't have that with them. And you've got two great coaches. Obviously Michael's resume speaks for itself. And, this is Kenya's first head coaching job, but, had time at LSU, has had some great experience here and it's just it's been great. You cannot argue with 20-0.
As a player, how would you like to say, okay, one of my coaches went 36-0 here in 2004 and won a national championship. My other coach went 36-0 here in 1999 as a player and won a national championship.
I'd probably say, dang, I better play pretty good. And for the most part, they do.
Lady Cardinals content to make it a half-court game at this point. 79-31. Have a travel. And we got a technical foul going to be called on Alano. She didn't think that she traveled, and she tossed the ball to the other end. And she's still talking, and she's getting real close to picking up a second one. The official's going over to Eric Taylor and saying, Coach, you might want to let her cool down, which is official doesn't have to do. So
anyway, he had his whistle in his mouth. He reached back for it and put it in his mouth. He was fixing to ring her up.
He was. Gardner going to the line to shoot the free throw. And it's in there. It's the second technical foul tonight against the Lady Gators, as we saw Eric Taylor, the coach, pick up one earlier in the first half.
11 points now for Gardner.
It's a nice night for her. I've really been more excited about her, just an all-out effort we saw there, especially in the first half on the defensive end and getting after some loose balls that were on the floor. Ball will stay with the Lady Cardinals. We got a question here at the scorer's table. We'll get that straightened up. Should mention we've talked about Michael and Kenya Landers, but we also got Courtney Simmons back as assistant coach this year. Of course, Courtney played here for Michael Landers back on one of his teams in his early tenure here at Trinity Alley, in his first tenure, I should say. And it's good to have Courtney back as well. Handling pass to Barrett. One-hander, no good. Rebound is controlled by McWright for the Lady Gators. Lady Gators on the attack. McWright takes it the distance. No good. Out of bounds. It's going to belong to the Lady Gators.
Good job by Leanne O'Say there. Tried to take a charge, but the best part about it was she didn't commit a blocking foul. Just kind of stood there and definitely altered McWright's shot.
Inbounds. Well, you can just definitely see how Allen is the leading scorer for the Lady Gators on the season. There's a long pass down to Gardner. No good. Foul is going to be called on Allen. But as I was saying, Jaleesa Allen, Jason, you can really see why she's the leading scorer for the Lady Gators, because when she's on the floor, she's always trying to make things happen.
Yeah, and she had a nice move right there. I can't remember who was down there playing defense. Maybe it was around Kiwana Gardner, who's at the free throw line right now. Just kind of sidestepped the big arms and made a great shot.
Gardner hits the free throw. Jaleesa Allen is a 6-foot freshman from Lamarck. She's not too far from home when she's on campus there for the Lady Gators. Lamarck, of course, got a great football program.
14 points now for Gardner off the bench for Trinity Valley. Lead back to 50.
Great steal by Barrett, but she loses her footing and is going to be fouled. But you just never like to see her take the tumble with that knee brace on and the knee injury that she sustained last year that cost her all but like 3 games of her freshman season. She got a medical red shirt, so she actually has another season which she could play next year if she chooses to come back. Gets the free throw to fall. Neither team in the double bonus yet. But both teams in the bonus.
12th point. And 13. A lot better showing at the free throw line right now. They're 7 of their last 8.
85-33. Still 12 and a half minutes left in the game.
9 of 10 here in the second half on the free throw line, Benny. That's good.
You can see a little bit of difference in the defensive attitude, let me call it, of the Lady Cardinals after that timeout. You know that Kenya Landers said, okay, let's step this up here and not get lazy on defense, not fall into bad habits here the remainder of the game. You can see them working far harder. Three-pointer, no good air ball. Gardner with the rebound. O'Say controls the loose ball down the floor to Barrett. Barrett did a great job of controlling it to Robinson. No good. There's Brandy Days, no good. And controlled by the Lady Gators. And we're going to have Leanne O'Say drawing a charge. Great job. That's one of those things that don't necessarily score up in the box score, Jason, but the coaches love to take note of those charges.
Yeah. And like we had mentioned, you know, she had done that on a couple of possessions ago, did a good job of kind of standing the ground but not blocking and just kind of standing still and paid off that time with a charge.
And there's a foul on Allen there. That's just a reaching foul. That's trying to play defense with your arms and your hands and not moving your feet is all that is. What used to tell my little dribblers.
And I don't, you know.
Half of whom used to listen. First free throw attempt is not very pretty. Jose misses the first one. Get the second attempt. Lady Cardinals will be shooting a double bonus the rest of the way. 85-33. Again, the one late women's score we had for you, I think the first half we had Kilgore leading Jacksonville 33-24.
That's 4 points now for Ose.
Ose, can you see?
Ose, I saw it.
86-33.
You can see that defensive intensity picking up, obviously, with the Lady Cards trying to do a better job of just denying the basketball.
Pull-up jumper's no good. Daze controls. Well, she doesn't control the rebound. Oh, we have an injury. Boy, you could just see it on her face when she went down. That's going to hurt her. That's going to be Bergwin that was injured. Hope it was just more of a shock to her system than anything else, but you could just see the expression on her face when she hit Jason, and she immediately grabbed her knee. So
yeah, not good.
Hopefully that's not anything too serious.
You see a trainer there working on her left knee, trying to straighten it out. You can see she is in a lot of pain. Looks like she may be getting ready to get up here.
Jason, we'll take a look at the Lady Cardinals game-by-game results. Again, of course, the first time these two teams played, it was 88-66, as we mentioned, but you look at these last three home games, you beat Panola 115-56, Tyler 103-67, and Southwest Christian 106-68. So it looks like the Lady Cardinals may put up a 100 count for a fourth straight home game.
And that's impressive. That's a nice run. And you know, of all the things, there's so many different intangibles, but another one is that when you come here, you think, golly, they're putting up a C note every time you come here, you know, and that just kind of maybe gets in your head a little bit.
And you got to remember, Kilgore's got to come back here for the second game. The Lady Cardinals have already won down there. Of course, Angelina's got to come here, and then Blinn will be here next week. Free throw is good. We'll mention that our next webcast will be next Wednesday night at 5:30 or 5:15. We'll start with the pregame. The Lady Cardinals will be playing Blinn. And in the second game of next week's doubleheader, the Cardinals will be playing Lee College. So we'll have a split doubleheader of sorts next Wednesday night.
Those are my favorite.
You like those, don't you? You get bored. Lady Cardinals trying to get the ball to Scott inside. Can't control it. They'll say over to Robinson. Scott flashes, asks for it. Can't get it to her. Now she gets the ball down low. Going to make a move back out to Gardner. Gardner with the drive, spots Barrett underneath, and Barrett puts it up and in. Great job that time by the Lady Cardinals of knowing where each other were going to be and seeing the floor. Air ball from about 10 feet, controlled by Robinson. Ose on the attack to Barrett. Barrett thought about driving baseline, turned it down over to Gardner. Over to Scott in the corner, three-pointer, and Scott knocks down the three-pointer. Jasmine Scott gets in on the act. And now we're 91-35, and we're not even we're coming up on the 10-minute mark, I should say, of the game.
That's seven for Scott. That previous bucket for Janae Barrett put her at 15, and that's tied for the game high here. 0 points for Caples in the second half, but, you know, she hasn't seen much time, if any at all.
Shot, nice shot by Demisha Hewitt. Yeah, it's not – they really haven't needed Shekayla this half, and they've let a lot of players get playing time. Scott puts up another three-pointer, no good. Foul's going to be on Kawana Gardner. 10-11 left in the game, 91-37.
And let the free throw shooting contest begin.
Not sure we'll see much of Caples the rest of the way. Looks like she's maybe...
she's taking the rubber band
out
of her
hair. So
I don't know women's basketball, but that looks like she may be done.
It's kind of like a football player not having his helmet on the sideline, I would think, maybe. Free throw attempt is good. I don't know if she called the bank or not, but she gets the free throw.
See that
Shepherd with the free throw.
Sanjak's gone to the no-rebound approach.
Second one is good. And we're approaching the 10-minute mark, 91-39.
What's the thinking behind that, Benny?
I'm not sure at this point. Nina Cook is now in the game. Dishes it off to Robinson. Robinson loses the ball, and the Lady Gators can't control it. And he goes out of bounds and will stay with the Lady Cardinals.
good effort there by Daisy Alonu.
The best answer to your question is she knew that she was going to make both free throws.
That's one possible answer.
Over to Cook in the corner. Goes down low to Robinson. McKinney puts up a three-pointer from the corner. No good. Scott with the rebound to Robinson. Robinson up and under. No good. And it belongs to the Lady Gators. Three-pointer top of the key. No good. Well, you got to give it to the Lady Gators. They're hanging in there, Jason, and still playing hard. Three-pointer, no good. Shepherd with the three-point miss. Ball out of bounds. Belongs to the Lady Cardinals. I'd be interested to see what kind of pace we see in the men's game, Jason, and what kind of pace that Pat Smith's willing to play with San Jacinto. Is he ready? You're going to let him get up and down the floor? You're going to try to slow it down? Going to be interesting to see.
Yeah, I don't know. It seems to me like anytime I think about a San Jack team, they're quick and they shoot very well.
Last year, the game played down in Pasadena. The only time they played, San Jacinto won 82-68. So it was a 14-point game. But I will say the Cardinals have had success against San Jacinto since Pat Smith has been here. I know they've got two or three wins during that time. 91-39, 9 minutes left in the game. A great drive by Alanu. She took it all the way. Couldn't get the shot to fall. Brittany Dukes takes it all the way. Going to be called for the charge.
Well,
that was a good job that time by Carrier, getting her feet set and taking the charge. It's called taking one for the team there.
And especially from Dukes.
She goes full force. You wouldn't want to stand in front of her.
And she does. And I don't know if you remember from last year before we went to Kansas, we talked to a lot of these girls. Of course, now it's just Dukes and Dunn that are back. But Dukes said she was always the one out in the yard playing football with the boys and all that. And you better believe she could probably put a good lick on you.
Yep. Always smiling, too.
Yeah.
There's Dukes with the attempted steal that'll knock the ball out of bounds. See her smiling out there now. That's a half smile. Trying to get this one over, no injuries. Rebound controlled by Dunn. Gets it to McKinney. McKinney to Scott. Scott puts up the shot, no good, controlled by Brittany Dukes. Nina Cook over to Barrett. Barrett with a long step drive. That first step was a doozy.
Look at that, Scott.
Lady Gators push the ball down the floor.
Alicia Dunn and Alice Robinson have done a nice job.
Scott puts up the shot. Excuse me, Jason. Scott puts up the shot that was blocked by McWright.
Done a nice job has Alice Robinson and Jasmine Scott and Alicia Dunn on the board tonight. They just always seem to be in the right place.
Inbound goes to Dukes. Thought about the three-pointer. Back over to McKinney. Inside to Dunn. Dunn puts up the shot. Not a very good shot that time and doesn't get it to fall.
Got to go up stronger than that.
Yeah, that was a little timid. Dunn's going to be called with the foul. She got her money's worth that time. She's going to send Shepherd to the line to shoot two, assuming that she can stay in the game. She's a little bit shaken up on the play. She's going to have to leave the game unless they call a timeout because the trainer came out on the floor to check on her. Thank you for all for looking in tonight on the Cardinal Sports Network. Again, we'll have the men's game to follow. Take a short break in between games and be back with you as the Cardinals try to pull off the upset of the number two ranked Ravens. First free throw attempt is good. Ashia Bergwin. -43-41. McKinney. It's a jumper. Good. She's had a pretty nice shooting night tonight. Nice jumper there, soft jumper.
6 points for McKinney.
Seems like it's more than that, but she's done a good job of running the offense for sure.
She's a great rebounder. It seems like she's all over the floor. She's a great rebounder.
Going to be a travel.
Carrier
going against Dace. Lost her footing, turned it over. Lady Cardinals quickly to Nina Cook. Brandy Dace puts up the jumper. No good. Dace follows her shot, but goes over the back, and it'll be called for the foul. Double bonus. It's going to send Carrier to the free throw line to shoot two. Lady Cardinals just kind of took the crowd out of the game tonight because they got up such a fast start that the crowd just kind of been sitting back now waiting for the men's game, or at least that's kind of the sense that you get here in the building.
Well, you know, there's probably two ways to take your own home crowd out of the game. That would be the chosen method.
Yes. You wouldn't want to do the opposite, that's for sure. Missed the first free throw.
Now, they had hit seven. They were 0-9 in the first half. That was seven in a row.
And makes the second.
That streak was finally broken there with that first free throw by Carrier.
95-42, Lady Cardinals within five of hitting the 100-point mark for the fourth straight home game. Great job. Well, that was just a nice job of Melissa Jackson flashing into the lane, McKinney hitting her with the soft pass and making the shot easy.
6 points for Melissa Jackson.
Nina Cook with the steal, going to take it coast to coast, puts up the layup, misses the layup. Brittany Dukes with the rebound, can't get the shot to fall. It's going to be fouled by Alanu. Well, Nina Cook made a great steal, just could not get it to fall. Alice Robinson is going to check back into the game for the Lady Cardinals, as is Portia Jewell for the Lady Gators.
Seen the last of Ilanu for this game. That's five fouls. And she did a good job hustling tonight, Benny, especially
well, she did.
And, you know, considering the circumstances.
Considering the circumstances, you're right. Dukes misses the free throw again. This is an area in which the Lady Cardinals are going to have to get straightened out as they head down the stretch and into February and into March, because free throws do add up just like the other shots do. Misses the second.
Makes them 10 of 14 now in the second half. They were 11 of 19 in the first half from the line. Keeps Duke stuck at 4 points.
Three-pointer, no good. Offside rebound by Carrier. Lady Cardinals in a position where they can just kind of call the score now the rest of the way. Turnover, steal by Dace. Passes it out to Dukes. Fights off pressure. Over to Cook. Cook puts up a three-pointer, no good. Rebound to Dace. Dace puts a shot up, no good. Dace back up and is fouled. Shot doesn't fall. Brandy Dace to the free throw line, 6'3 sophomore from Harlan, New York.
Back-to-back possessions, Sanjak has lost a player to fouls. Jewell will now lead the game with five fouls. And I think Jewell, as you see her leave the court, looks like probably the entire team feels. Just golly, what a night.
I don't think there will be a lot of energy on the bus on the drive home tonight. Free throw is no good. Jackson's going to be called for the, it's a two-shot foul.
Okay. Well, she was headed for the over-the-back foul, wasn't she?
She definitely was. And the score has slowed down for the Lady Cardinals here in the second half. They're now at 98-42. Seems certain that they'll, almost a certainty that they'll be 100 points or more for a fourth straight home game. D again, the Lady Gators are just giving it everything they've got, but they're just outmanned at this point. Of course, they've lost a couple of players now to fouls. But you saw Berglund trying to create something that time inside. Brittany Dukes running the offense. Cook drives the baseline, puts up the shot, and draws the foul. Good aggressive move by Nina Cook. As we come up on the 5-minute mark, Cook's got a chance to put more points on the board. Gets the first one to fall. She hits this one. The Lady Cardinals will be the 100-point mark for a fourth straight home game.
And everybody gets free gorditas.
Whatever.
Courtesy of Benny Rogers.
100-42 with 5:04 left in the game. Yeah, you can just sense the crowd is just waiting for the men's game now. I mean, it's everybody just kind of sitting back in a relaxed atmosphere.
No offense, but me too.
Jackson with the rebound off the miss by Berglund. Osei on the move. Is it to Gardner? Jackson thought about three, said drive, puts up the shot, draws the foul. Melissa Jackson missed the first few games of the season with a hand injury, but she's been back since then, has really done a nice job for the Lady Cardinals and has fit into the rotation very well.
She may be one of those players, Benny, that, you know, maybe she starts hitting a little bit more of a stride as she hit the first free throw, hitting a little more of a stride as you get to clutch time, you get to the regional tournament and beyond possibly.
No question about that. Second free throw is good.
8 points for Jackson now. A lot of double-digit scores for Trinity Valley
right now. Got everybody in the books tonight, just about?
Almost. I think we do, actually, because Carnita Bunch is out with the injury, correct?
Right. That's correct.
Yeah, that's everybody. And as this half has slowed down, you realize you look up, and now they've turned that lead into a 60-point lead.
She forces up the shot as the shot clock was winding down. Yeah, you're right, Jason, real kind of quietly, too. Jose goes all the way, coast to coast, puts up the layup, won't get it. Dace puts up the shot. She's blocked. Lady Gators on the attack. They get the ball down the floor to Hewitt. She hits the layup. See, Dace is real frustrated with herself out there, just reading her body language. Jackson puts up the shot. Oh, a soft one off the top of the board almost. Not sure she called it. 104-44.
Excuse me, 10 points now for Jackson. Dukes is in double figures. Caples is in double figures. She had hers before she ever played a second in the second half. Gardner, Barrett, Dace.
Robinson on the rebound. Not the prettiest trip down the floor. Gardner's going to take it. That's uncontested there. Well, you got to give it to the Lady Cardinals, folks, because sometimes when you come out against an opponent that you know that you're better than, it's not easy to be focused and to play, especially when it's your fourth game in 7 days. But that was not the case tonight. And they're going to win this one in no sweat fashion. This one was decided very early when they jumped out to like a 12-0 lead. There's a turnover. Osei over to Gardner. They definitely got numbers. She puts up the layup. No good. Osei with the rebound puts it up. No good. Gardner puts it up. No good. Dace is going to try it. No good. Block. Gardner puts up the shot. It's going to draw the foul. And after all of that, it's going to get the bucket and have a chance at a three-point play. Well, the shooting percentage was not good on that trip down the floor to have the numbers like they did, but they may wind up with a three-point play out of all of it.
Well, 4 straight offensive rebounds.
The loss tonight, the Lady Gators are going to fall to 6-13 on the season. and 1-6 in conference play. The Lady Cardinals will improve to 21-0 on the season, 9-0 in conference play, and maintain their conference lead. It was an unforced error. No pressure defense at all that time. No defense at all by the Lady Cardinals, and the Lady Gators threw it away. So
quietly, Gardner has moved up 19 points to lead all scorers, Benny. That's 19 off the bench. You like to see that.
Nice to have that out of her. You're right. Nina Cook behind the pick, over in the corner to Osei.
And you just get the sense with every one of these players, like Nina Cook coming in, they want to show something. They want to prove that they can hang.
Osei with a three-pointer from the corner. No good. Battling for the rebound. Scott puts it up and fouled. Takes a shot in the eye, and you got Gardner also down with an injury. They're both okay. They both took hard shots. I think Jasmine may have lost her contact. Looks like she did.
Ouch. In the last 4 minutes now, you're seeing another Lady Gator leave the floor with fouls. I'm not so sure Scott's going to be able to make this free throw unless they call a timeout.
She's got to get it in first. I was too squeamish. I could never wear contacts.
It's glass in your eye, sort of.
So what did I do? I went and had a LASIK surgery. Let them point a laser at my eye.
Benny, is this paid advertising going on? Yeah, I just don't. Not a fan of sticking my finger in my own eye. And that's contact talk. Here with 156 left.
Mention to folks that are watching Points Beyond that we had a real cool day here in Athens, Texas. The temperature finally creeped into the 50s. The sun broke out. We're supposed to have a real cold day tomorrow. Temperatures dropping into the 30s by afternoon with strong northerly winds. So we're going to have a little winter time again here in Athens, Texas. Free throw attempt is no good. They got to hit those free throws. Don't care what the score is, you got to hit your free throws.
Good looking freshman, Benny.
Oh, yeah, going to be a player for the future, that's for sure.
At least 2 years.
Yep. Missed both free throws, though. There's Allen dishing off. Gardner with the steal. Gets it out to Osei. Lady Cardinals still pushing the basketball. Osei takes it all the way, gets it to fall. 111-44. 133 and counting left in the game.
6 points for Osei now. Jasmine Scott is out of here.
Oh, nice move and shot by Bergwin. Gets the bucket to go. Coming up on a minute left in the game. Nice job of spotting Robinson underneath. Doesn't get the shot to fall. Saves it from going out of bounds, though. Robinson always hustling over to Gardner in the corner. Three-pointer up and in. Oh, what a fitting way for that's the final. That winds up being the final shot for the Lady Cardinals. 114-46. A three-pointer by Gardner. That puts her at about, 22 points?
22 points. Easily leads all scorers.
It's her season high, too. McWright lowers her shoulder and goes all the way. Misses the shot. Draws a foul. Foul is on Robinson. That's her first. Yeah, two shots for McWright. First one's no good. Again, folks, I hope you'll join us for the men's game. It should be a good one. The Cardinals, 15-3 versus the number two ranked Ravens at 17-1. It should be a good one. I mean, there's just no other way to advance it. It just should be a good one. Second free throw doesn't fall. Now the Lady Cardinals would probably put up one more shot before they would run out the shot clock if they got an opportunity, because this one's been decided a long time ago. Gardner thought about a three-pointer from the corner, decides, drives baseline, puts up the shot, and draws a foul. Foul is going to be on Wendy Mitchell. Oh, check that. That's my bad. It's on Jaleesa Allen. That's five on Jaleesa Allen, and she didn't start tonight.
Four foul outs for Sanjak.
Making the most of their fouls.
Whew. Yeah.
Ebony Atkins is going to check into the game for the Lady Gators to finish up. Free throw is up and good. And I think the Lady Cardinals high on the season's 116, I believe it is, Jason.
I believe that's right.
The other night against Panola. That's where they're at now. They won't take another shot, though. It's 116-46. Three-pointer is up and no good. Done with the rebound. Lady Cardinals just run out the clock at this point. So that's going to do it. The Lady Cardinals are going to take a convincing 116-46 win over the San Jacinto Lady Gators. They're going to run their record to 21-0 on the season, 9-0 in conference play. They're going to protect their number two national ranking. They'll have a huge game Saturday when they go to Jacksonville to play a red-hot Lon Morris team. Lon Morris was off tonight, so they've had a full week to rest for the game. Lady Cardinals will need to match the type intensity they had tonight, that's for sure. Lady Gators are going to close tonight's game with a record of 6-13 overall and 1-6 in conference play. We're going to step away for a few minutes. We'll come back to you with about 5 minutes left in warm-ups for the men's game. May give you some totals from this game, and we'll set up the men's game. So we'll be back here momentarily on the Cardinals Sports Network with the men's game.